everyone. Hi.
Hi.
Thank you very much to attend my presentation, my session today. Actually, this is my first time to present in this big stage. Please, I'm so sorry if I'm so much smiling because it can reduce my stage fright and.
Let's give up to you.
And it will reduce my nerves too. So today I will present about the cloud-based mobile application testing with Appium. So actually this is, I will tell you my experience in my company as the test engineers, how we can do automation daily and how we can reduce the time for doing automation tests, so we can do daily deployment every day. And it is me. My name is Aisyah Dzulqaidah. You can call me Aisyah. I'm from Indonesia. I think it's on the Southeast Asia. And if you see my information in the website, it told that I'm from BBM. Actually, I'm from the KMK Labs. BBM is one product of KMK Labs. But the BBM is already, BBM consumer is already off at the 21st May. But so we continue our product to the video.com. And this is my LinkedIn link. So anyone already know what is video? No, you know. Actually, the main target is only for Indonesian people. So it's the most popular streaming application in Indonesia after YouTube. We can do live streaming, video sharing, and also there are premium video subscription in video. We also we are available on iOS platform, Android, web, and mobile site. So we have to maintain this all application. We, as a test engineer, we check the story, we check the feature. And also do also write automation test, so it's not separated from the checking feature and also the automation test. We do both. So the outline is first why we run automation using the cloud devices, and then how we do the parallel test to reduce the automation test time, and I also will explain more about how to spawn and how to get the online emulator in cloud. And specifically, I will demo using the Genymotion Cloud. And then I will demo to run tests using Appium robot framework and Genymotion Cloud. So first, I will why we using cloud. First we should run automation test against multiple OS version. There are so many variations, like the brand and also the OS version for iOS and also for the Android version. And if we test it using the real device, it will be more hard and it will take one more time, and the maintenance cost also, we have to maintain the maintenance cost is really costly. So and there are also scalability issues using desktop simulator. In BBM and video, we have 100 tests, more than 100 tests. So, and we should deploy every day, and if we run it not parallel, it will take a long time. And when we first using the desktop, I will tell you the chronology. First, when I enter my company, it's still using the desktop simulator, and it's hard to make the parallel because we have to spawn many simulator in one server, but there are performance issue using it. And then when we found the solution that is using the Genymotion Cloud, and we start to change our test to parallel test using Genymotion Cloud. And when we use cloud, it is easier, and we can integrate it to the CI. So this is what we use. These are what we use on the daily automation. For the Android application, we use Android SDK, specifically using the ADB. We also use the Appium, and also we use the GM SaaS, Genymotion Software as a Service. For the test, we use robot framework, and it's run on the GCP slaves. For the iOS testing, we use a simulator from the Xcode, and using Appium robot framework. And Xcode simulator actually is not cloud, but we run it on the Mac Stadium. It's like the virtual machine for the iOS. So why we use the Genymotion software as a service? First, because it's the Android device is running directly as virtual machine on the cloud, so we don't have to maintain the virtual machine, and also we can spawn as many as virtual devices as we want without we thinking about the performance in our server. Second, it's also compatible with the Appium, the engine that we use, and we can also interact with this screen or virtual device using the website in the browser without any plugin. And also we can spawn multiple virtual machine in parallel, so we enable the parallel test. And it's also easy to set up. Why I say that it's really easy? Because of we don't have to install the desktop version. We just can install it via Python package using the pip install gm sas. Also set the SDK path so the Genymotion can interact with the ADB using the gm sas config set Android like this. And also we can list the device that we can see the device using the gm sas recipes list, and we also can create the template for the device on the Android, and we can share right into the cloud. And for connecting to the ADB, it's use gm sas instance like this, ADB connect instance UID, and to stop the device, we use this. So how we can do parallel tests on simulator using Appium? For the Android, we have to use these capabilities. We have to differentiate the ports for these three capabilities. For Android, we have to, for each test case that we want to parallelize, we have to assign different ports for different tests that we want to run. and also the unit for the every test and push support. And for iOS, there are specific capabilities that we have to use. We have to state the device name, platform version, and also the web driver agent local port. So I will do the demonstration for using the Genymotion Cloud. So for today's demonstration, I will. This is the robot framework test. So there are switch setup. With setup, because we want to skip the launch. And why I use the robot framework, because it's really, really easy to read. We can see that we have three scenario. We have one switch test and three test case. First, we want to search from the trending keywords on the video. And second, we have to test search in the video tab. And third is test search in user tab. You can see the step in on the below of the test case name. So I will make it parallel for every test. This is the simple script, really simple script, how we can make the three tests parallel for each test. First, we have to start the device. We can use this command line using GM. This one is the instance UID. You can find the UID using the GM slash recipe list yang, as I said before. And second, we have to connect the cloud devices to ADB so the ADB can access the device on the cloud. And then install application to the device. And for this line, this is the how we different the how we differ how make the port different for every test. I have three cell script on this. I'm different. I make it different for first test. It use this port. It will be different to another script. So what we have to make it different is UDID that we get from the start when we start the devices, we will get the UDID. And also the port, we have to differentiate the port and also the booster port. And specific, I put the specific test on this comment. And then after we run the test, we stop the device. And on the when we run the test, we also can get the log from after it run. Because I think the connection is not really good, I will show you the video that I have recorded before. This one is the website to see the list of device in Genymotion. So this we can see that we can view the device. And we do the installation. And run the test. We will wait for the application to show up. And that's all. When after this. This test is takes a long time because it's finding the search result for every section. And after the test is finished, we can stop the device, and the device is stopped. Actually, this is really simple. You can grow it. You can put the subscript on this. The CI, maybe it's just the simple step. You can give the extension to that, and I think this is you don't have not only three, you can use more than 10 devices to run parallel, and it also work in my company. It's just the demonstration, so I just show you three devices, but it can extend to more than 10 devices on parallel using Genymotion Cloud. If you have any question about Genymotion Cloud, you can visit the booth on booth 4 in Genymotion Cloud in the main street, I mean the main hall. And that's all for me. Thank you.